Their retail campaign is just the initiative. It introduces the consumer to Falling Whistles through a proactive point of purchase and an easy step of action. They make it so anybody can buy a whistle, so anybody can feel like they're helping, without actually getting their hands dirty. Their ultimate goal is to create leaders in peace, and create the demand for peace along with those leaders. This illustrates the law of explosive growth, because to add growth, you must lead followers, but to multiply that effect, you lead leaders. According to the law of picture, people do what people see. By wearing a whistle, you inspire others to, just like by advocating for peace in large numbers, people will follow suit. So by doing this, they need to do two things. The first being to stop cycles of violence, and they do so by 1. Rehabilitation, and 2. Retail. Secondly, they want to create a global coalition for their cause. This they accomplish by organizing and coalition itself. John Maxwell states, "Anyone can steer the ship, but it takes a leader to chart the course." Having a clear vision of where the company is headed and how to get there is just one of the many attributes that Sean contributes to the company. Their rehabilitation strategy is this: 1. Expression therapy, 2. Psychosocial support, 3. Job training, and 4. Education. Through education, they really incorporate the law of process. They teach a new generation of rehabilitated children to inherit value and the power of their individual voice. They also teach their basic rights as a human being.
It is through process that they revitalize local schools, communities, and Congolese culture. The next part of their strategy is to implement the coalition, the Campaign for Peace in Congo. The Falling Whistles DC tour was from November 11th through 12th in various participating DC area venues. It hosted multiple fundraisers, and Sean Carrasco himself attended all the events and gave several speeches.
On their website, they give opportunities to organize a tour date in your city. They give the power of coalition to the people. Falling Whistles touch the heart of many people. The law of connection is used through Facebook and Twitter, the top social networks in the world. The more the freedom story is heard, it can be passed on from friend to friend across the world.
Falling Whistles is a team-based organization. However, what Falling Whistles doesn't say on their website is how much the interns have contributed and how greatly they are valued as decision makers and assets to the team.
When Falling Whistles first started, they were working out of a garage, and the interns called shots that helped them move into a downtown office in LA. They biked thousands of miles, donned suits to travel to D.C. and work in their advocacy office, and have been the life and the vitality of Falling Whistles. Falling Whistles' management team displays natural leadership skills that are rare to find within the same organization. By Sean knowing when to take a step down and allowing others to lead, the law of empowerment certifies that he is confident with his judgment as well as his staff's, allowing them to grow as a company. This is a quote found by Nick Sloper, a summer intern of 2010 for the Falling Whistles company. "I came into this internship not knowing what to expect. I dreamt it would be a nice experience, something fun to do for a summer. I wasn't at all prepared for what I got myself into. Never in my life had I faced such challenges, felt such frustrations, or worked into the early hours of the morning to complete something that actually matters. At the same time, I've never been so at home, so at peace, or so in love with my life. I don't think many people have the chance to feel this way, but I hope it someday happens to you. The people here have become my best friends, my family. And my life has been changed forever by Falling Whistles, opening my eyes to a new world of possibility and endless ability to achieve my dreams."
Nick's quote is an example of not just influence, but more importantly, the law of addition.
The Falling Whistles environment is stimulating with non-stop action. They have office dance parties, and they motivate their employees by making work fun and adventurous. Here's an example of Falling Whistles inspiring fellow whistleblowers of peace to take matters into their own hands. On December 26, 2010, 5 adventurous whistleblowers began their journey up Mount Kilimanjaro. For every foot it took to reach the summit, they pledged to donate $1 to Falling Whistles. They climbed 19,334 feet, and in return, donated $19,334 to Falling Whistles. This is an example of the law of influence. Having to make sacrifices is one thing that I believe most people would agree is a given when it comes to keeping a business successful.
The sacrifices that Falling Whistles and their dedicated peaceblowers have made can be seen in everything that they do. Whether it's a selfless act to donate 100% of all proceeds to the cause, or something as small as taking a little time from their day to enlighten others of how to get involved, the law of sacrifice is shown to be clearly understood. New leaders will portray the law of legacy. People such as myself will continue to support countries at war such as Congo. It's a challenge that will be taken even if the mission is not accomplished. There will always be someone trying to save the world, and leaders will always be determined and always keep faith that the war will end one day. Donations will continue to give the children hope, and more leaders will make a positive change.
Overall, we find Falling Whistles to be a truly unique, selfless, team-based company. Being able to have workers and volunteers that are devoted to a cause just as much as you are takes a great deal of trust and respect. Sean Carrasso displays wonderful leadership skills by giving everyone the chance to play equally important roles in the decision-making process. He empowers his workers to voice their opinions and gives them say on upcoming projects. On top of that, they are open to ideas from other sources, not just their employees, which further shifts their empowerment from the organization and to the people themselves. By allowing everyone to participate equally, their influence as an organization has endless potential. We think what makes Sean such an effective leader is that he is nobody special with particular power or wealth. He is just a peace-loving adventurer who has a pure heart and the will and the motivation to encourage others. We would all like to work for this company if given the chance. If we were the CEOs, the only thing we would change would be the amount of collaborative work that they do with other nonprofits that support the same cause. They already work with a few, but we believe that in a global pursuit for peace, they would be much more effective in the long run in a cooperative work environment.